Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So we've already seen the theory part of flow through pipes. We've seen different types of losses, major losses, minor losses. Now let's do few numericals and try to understand how the formula and everything is related in numericals, and we'll calculate the losses of head in different cases, in minor losses as well as in major losses. So the fourth question is, I'll read out the question. A pipeline AB of diameter 300 mm and of length 400 meter carries water at the rate of 50 liters per second. So the discharge is given in terms of LPS. So you need to convert in meter cube per second. The flow rate takes place from A to B, where point B is 30 meter above point A. Find the pressure at A if the pressure at B is 19.62 Newton per centimeter square. So the pressure at B is given, the pressure at A has to be found, and the value of friction factor is given as 0.08. So let's start doing this numerical. Before, let's first write down the given data and then solve. The pressure is given in terms of Newton per centimeter square, so let's convert into SI unit Newton per meter square. So the logic behind solving this question is, you have to calculate the velocity of the pipe first using the discharge equation Q is equal to A into V. Once you get the velocity, you can use Bernoulli's equation between point A and B. And in Bernoulli's equation, everything is known except for the pressure at point B. The pressure at A is known, the velocity at both the ends are same. Since it is a uniform pipe, so there will be no change in velocity, and the datum, the difference in the head, the datum head is also given. So the only unknown remains is the pressure head at point B. So that can be easily found out if you use Bernoulli's equation between point A and B. Since the velocity at A and B is equal, so we can cancel both the terms easily. So after using the Bernoulli's equation, once you put down all the values into the equation, you'll get the value of pressure at B as 1.26 into 10 to 5 Newton per meter square. And if you want to convert it into Newton per centimeter square, multiply it by 10 to minus 4. Since the pressure at A was given in terms of Newton per centimeter square, it's more proper to write the same pressure at B Newton per centimeter square in the same units. Even if you keep in Newton per meter square, there's no problem, it's one and the same. So that was all about this question. I hope you have understood this.